Hi friends, now our topic is about Red Data Book. Coming to the Red Data Book, what is a Red Data Book? So, species are judged as threatened are listed by various agencies as well as by some private organization. The most cited of these lists is the Red Data Book. It is a loose leaf volume of information on the status of many kinds of species. This volume is continually updated and is issued by International Union for the Conservation of Nature, IUCN, located in the Morges, Switzerland. Next, red. Of course, it is a symbol of danger that these species, both plants and animals, presently experience throughout the globe. The Red Data Book was being first issued in the year 1966 by the IUCN Special Survival Commission as a guide for the formulation, preservation and management of the species listed. In this book, information for endangered mammals and birds are more extensive than for the other groups of animals and plants. Coverage is also given to less prominent organisms facing extinction. There are organizations and institutions at the national and international level for the development and coordination of biodiversity conservation activities. So, Worldwide Fund for the Conservation of Plants and Animal Resources. So, IUCN, International Union for the Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, the Forest Survey of India, the Wildlife Institute of India, etc. are the examples of organizations and institutions. So, some of the species of animals and plants of India, subcontinent and neighboring regions that have entered in the Red Data Book. So, coming to the first, the clouded leopard. The endangered species. The clouded leopard is protected throughout the most of its range. Deforestation is the principal threat to the clouded leopard, although the seriousness depends upon the further study of the species. Tolerance of various degree of forest clearance. The clouded leopard is also widely hunted for its teeth, pelt and for the bones for the traditional Asian medicinal trade. Next, the Nilgiri. So, in the district of Idukki, near the Munnar, is the home of Nilgiri Thar. So, the Thars that exist in the high ranges in the Kerala are our Fenri allot. According to the reports, Thar appears to have a roamed at will in vast herbs all over the grassy uplands of the higher plateau of the Nilgiris. By closing the ears of the 19th century, uncontrolled hunting and poaching had, however, reduced the Thar to such an extent that their numbers are probably did not exceed 100. Next, the golden lion tamarin. So, the golden lion tamarin, tamarin's long silky fur, particularly at the shoulders, gives it a lion-like name. So, tamarins are some of the smallest members of the primate family. Next, the lion-tailed macaque. The lion-tailed macaque, so named from its lion-like tail, is the most threatened primate on our rainforest. Macaque seems to be unable to adapt to closely proximity to the humankind, preferring to live highly in the tree tops, so rarely venturing down to the forest floor. The main threat is to the lion-tailed macaque is the destruction of its habitat, occasionally persecution as crop pest, as well as its unfortunately resemblance to Nilgiri, which is considered to have a medicinal value. Next, Malabar Civet Cat. So, the Malabar large spotted civet's originally habitat was found in Malabar coast, moist forest bed below the Western Ghats, where it lived in the wooded plains and adjoining hilly slopes. It was once very common in the coastal districts of Malabar, so and Travancore. Extensive deforestation has been reduced the Malabar forest to a series of isolated patches. Cashew plantations are a refuge which probably hold most of the surviving population of the Malabar. So, the large spotted civet are now threatened by large-scale clearance of the rubber plantation. Next, the red panda. The red panda shares the giant panda's rainy high-altitude forest habitat but has a wider range. The red pandas are endangered. Victims of deforestation, their natural space is shrinking as more and more forests are destroyed by logging and the spreading of agriculture. So, thank you very much. Please do Like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel.